Hi, it's Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org. We're talking about various players that I've had contact with through the years, and it allows people to pray really for the players. And also, I think there are situations where players just hide reality from other people, and they're not really facing reality as to how to be a Christian. Some of them are Christians and they don't really act like Christians. And they don't talk like Christians, but they will say they're a Christian if you ask them. And then there are others that aren't Christians, and they also have their own mirrors that they hide behind. So I'm just trying to share a little bit about various players. Now today I'm going to talk about Vania King. Vania King has turned into one of the top doubles players in the world, top 10 for sure. She's won some Grand Slams. She's an American player. I first met her when she arrived on the scene. I was very close to her whole structure of how it happened getting on the Pro Tour, and I'm going to share that with you. Vania was a junior player. She was playing the junior event at the U.S. Open, and I don't remember the year it was, but her father was her coach, David. And she had her mother there, and she had her sister there. She has a few sisters that are also good players. And she has a brother who is a very good player, number one in the U.S. in juniors, actually, and tried to play the Pro Tour. So her father taught all her family, all her brothers and sisters, how to play tennis. So obviously he knows how to teach tennis. He's got he owned a Chinese restaurant in Long Beach, and that's how he used the funding to support his kids to travel to tournaments, and then he taught them the structure of the game. So I met Vania, and she burst on the scene. She was playing the juniors and doing pretty well. I don't remember how she did in that junior tournament, but what was stand out about that was she made it to the third round of the U.S. Open in the women's singles. Now that was an amazing thing, because it doesn't happen very often that a junior player even gets into the women's main draw, and then she went three rounds, and I was there with her for each match. I was working with her father, her mother, her, and kind of another coach who was somewhat like an advisor. So I was sitting in on that, and it turns out the family said, well, we're Christians. So I said, oh, that's fine. And, you know, we talk about spiritual things, the father and the mother and Vania. And Vania, because she was young, would basically just sit there and listen. But she was very, you know, she actually has some confidence. She could actually engage an older person in conversation. And I'm older, for sure. So she went on. And then the decision that needed to be made was whether she was going to turn pro or not. Because the prize money for that getting to the third round was $78,000. And the question was, and I was part of that conversation, they were asking me questions, my advice, my opinion, was whether she would go on to college and get a tennis scholarship and not turn pro at this point in time, or turn pro based upon the financial aspect of it. She's a very smart girl. Her sisters have gone to, and her brother have gone to really good schools like Princeton. And her objective was to go to a very high level Ivy League type school to study. She loves music, classical music, and is very gifted in music. So that was a very tough decision. She was very young. Her dad was talking to her about it, her mom and me, and we were, you know, basically the final decision, and agents were starting to be around. Now, there was, the agents cannot talk to you if you're an amateur, as I understand it. So that could jeopardize your standing as an amateur, and even your ability to go to college. So but the agents have ways to kind of be around, and you know, they're friendly, and they talk a little bit, and that was starting to happen. The other thing that happened was that it came down to deciding whether the money she could make as a pro tennis player could compensate for going to university after her pro career, the same amount of money that it would take to go to a university, would she be able to make that much money, put it in the bank, and then use that to go to the to go to a university, a high-level university? And it was decided that yes, she had the future to do that. So she turned pro during that U.S. Open and accepted the prize money. Now, I took her to a church in Queens, a few miles from the U.S. Open, where I had a good relationship, and she, Vania and I, she went forwards with me and accepted Christ at an altar call. So I asked her, I said, she's sitting right next to me with her mother and father, and I said, would you like to go and accept Christ in your life? And she said, yes. So she and I stood up and walked down to the altar, and she accepted Christ in her life. So that was the situation. Now, something I couldn't predict was that I went with David on the court with him. He was not super tough on her, not compared to other coaches or other parents that I saw. But you know, he was it was his daughter, and he made it so that she worked hard. And then he was also a little bit tough off the court on her, you know, with wanting her to do well. But I wouldn't say it was too extreme. But it for sure was tough on Vania. You know, she's 17 or 18, and she's just at that age where she's seeking independence. And also there was the cultural aspect. In Chinese culture, it tends to be that way where the elders have more influence on the people who are younger. So what happened was that the next I saw, and the mother was around. Now, she was very quiet. She wouldn't say anything. She just was a kind person to her daughter and nice, and she wasn't really involved in the actual tennis part of it, outside of just going and watching matches and encouraging her daughter. And the next thing I know, I see them at another tournament, and the relationships have all broken down in the family. David has stopped coaching his daughter. He stopped traveling with her. Vania stopped him from traveling with her. And this was the person who got her to the point she was at. And it hurt him a lot because I spoke to him about it. And he loved his daughter. He loved what she's accomplished. But I know it was painful for him. And he actually had to stay home. So he wasn't traveling with her for years and years. To this day, I don't think he still does, many years later. And all of a sudden, the mother became the one who was setting up her coaching, bringing in the coaches, and she became the key person in Vania's life with setting up how she was going to train, when she was going to, you know, racket stringing, tournaments, and she wasn't really a coach, and she doesn't even play tennis, know that much about tennis. And it turned out that I always sensed there was some distance between the mother and I. It wasn't a super close friendship. David, it was, the father, and also with Vania. But the mother is a little bit distant, and I could be friendly to her, but you know, she wasn't really willing to go much further than being friendly to being a friend. And what happened was that while David, the father, was in Los Angeles, he accepted Christ and became born again. And as I saw him at a tournament later on, it turned out it was a very legitimate accepting of Christ. He got very involved in his church. He was spirit-filled and born again, and the whole family was talking about it. The mother, the daughter noticed immediately, but she hadn't reached the point where she was really on fire for the Lord, you know? She just said, oh, Christ is the Lord of my life, that's it, okay? There wasn't more than that in her life. And so it turned out the mother, who I spoke with in a few tournaments, said, well, you know, I don't want to be that kind of a Christian where I actually have turned my life over to Christ. I just want to be a nice person, a social Christian, go to church when it's convenient. So there were some big problems among the family with their spiritual life. And I spoke to David, I emailed him a few times, I actually saw him at the Australian Open, and we flew back on a plane, Vania, David, and myself, because they happened to be on the same plane. I was flying out of Australia back to Hong Kong, and we were sitting near each other, so we were able to talk. And it turned out that there was a very much a spiritual imbalance in what was happening in the family. And all I could do was pray for Vania that she would really want to turn her life over to Christ and become a stronger Christian and not go in the direction of her mother, which was like a social Christian and didn't really wasn't that important to her. And to this day, I really don't know the circumstance there. And then David went back home. And what happened was that as I saw the mother and Vania in Tokyo, and all of a sudden, again, the mother had a lot of influence, but the father wasn't around, was that this coach started working with her, and he was really not, from a Christian standpoint, someone that I would suggest you have as a coach. He said foul language. He dressed very inappropriately. He didn't look like a professional coach, actually, and his manner was very negative. And this is who, and a lot of times in that case, you have a young girl and you have a slightly older man, and all of a sudden there becomes a physical relationship, which is very unhealthy for a player. Not easy to break that relationship. And then what happened was that that went on for a period of time, and all I could do was sit back, and he definitely wasn't supportive of me because of his attitude. And I couldn't do nothing except pray for her and smile at her. That's all I could do, because she was going in an opposite direction than where God was at, you could say. So I just prayed for her, and that's the situation as I know it. I don't know where she's at now. I just know that recently she did a press interview, and she said, "I'm a Christian. I'm non-denominational Christian." And my only advice there is get in a church and become a Christian in a church and act like you're a member of a church and start to participate in the church body. Even if you're on the pro tour, you need to have that. You can't just travel and say, "I'm a Christian," never go to church. That's not biblical. And that's Vania, and she has turned out well in her career, but she still has a long lifespan ahead of her. She's a very young person, and if she lives to be an old person like myself, she's going to go through a lot of difficulties, a lot of situations in her life, and you need to have Christ to be there, and you need to have fellowship with people, and you need to have accountability, spiritual accountability. To the best of my knowledge, she doesn't have that at this point in time. It's my prayer that she does.